All right, at this time, before we open the meeting of the School Board of Trustees, I have asked a pastor to come and give us a few words, and I've asked Pastor Amber to come tonight. And Pastor Amber has meant a lot to this community. She's done quite a bit since she's been here. She's leaving us in a month and a half, going to Mishawaka, which I know that they're getting a good pastor. So, like I said, our community's going to be deeply missing you, so at this time, I'll pass to Amber.
Thanks, how am I supposed to talk then when you say such nice things? Am I loud enough for you to hear me? Yeah, I got a lot of amens about that. I've thought a number of times of the great witness that we have in our school system here, that a pastor is invited to come and to deliver a short message and then have the gift of being able to pray. Pray for your students, pray for moms and dads, pray for teachers, pray for our board. What a great gift it is that we get to go to a school, we get to support a school that lets the Bible, lets prayer, lets positive things come to school. What a gift that is. And so I just want to lift that up as knowing, because I've lived here for 6 years, and what a gift it is to know that when our kids went through this school, a number of times we said, you know what, Mentone, it's a state school, but I'll tell you what, I know those teachers pray for our children, so it's the closest thing to a Christian school that a state school could go. I may not be allowed to say that, but I'm leaving in 6 weeks. So I can. And I want you to know how much it means to me, but then to all of us, moms and dads, to know that our teachers pray, that our school board prays for our students, prays for our teachers, that when we come together, that we've been prayed over. A lot of times people say, oh, they're not allowed to have prayer in school, they're not allowed to do this or that, and God has been taken out of school. Not as long as you and I come in and show God's love just by being a loving person. They can't take God out of that because God is in you and me. And in my 6 years of living here, I would say that our area, we've seen our, there is no share, but we have seen a lot of tragedy. And so a number of times when I've been invited to come and to share with all of you, it's been immediately following some sort of horrible thing that all of us just feel like our world has just stopped. And so in those moments, we often lean on clergy to be able to help us make sense of things. But I'll be honest with you, sometimes as clergy, all we can do is hurt with you because we hurt as well. So the greatest thing that I have seen, the greatest thing that I want to lift up, the greatest thing about this community is that we know how to show love, share love, and spread love. That when push comes to shove, we may have disagreements on this thing or that thing, or we're disappointed about that. But when everything settles down, this is a community that knows how to show love, share love, and spread love. And, you know, when I started in ministry, I never thought that I could open up my phone and be able to read God's word straight from my phone. But I thought that I would tonight. So I'd like to share with you from 1 John, where it simply says, "Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love." Every time that we reach out and love one another, we are sharing God's love. What a great gift that is, and what great peace that it has brought all of us together through these last seasons of great celebrations and then also heartbreak and heartache that we've journeyed together. So I would leave you with the words that no matter where you go and what you do and how you serve, that if we can show love, share love, and spread love, then we're making this world a better place. And that's the greatest gift, and that is a great gift that this school district brings to all of us, that we get to do that together. So with that being said, let me pray for us, and then we'll turn the meeting back over to these guys. Let's pray. Holy God, we thank you for the opportunity that we have to lift up your word on this night. Lord, we thank you for the opportunity that we have to speak your name and your son's name. Lord God, I pray for each person who's here today. Lord, I pray for each student, each teacher, each staff member, our school board members, as we are starting to see the end of this school year come. Lord, I pray that your love would always be lifted up, and that each one of us would always continue to show love and share love and spread love, because we know that we are loved by you. And all of God's people said,
Amen. Thank you, Pastor Emily. At this time, I'll open the Tippecanoe Valley School Board of Trustees with all members present. Superintendent Mr. Boggs, Assistant Superintendent Mr. Conley, Recording Secretary Mrs. McFarland, and our student representatives. The upcoming board meetings, June 13, 2016, the regular meeting at the administration office at 6:30 p.m. June 27, 2016, a CPF workshop at the administration office at 6:30 p.m. July 11, 2016, regular meeting at the administration office at 6:30 p.m. And on August 8, 2016, regular meeting at the Minton Elementary School at 6:30 p.m. And at Building Trades Open House on Sunday, May the 15th from 1 to 4 p.m. And the Alternative Education Program graduation is Thursday, May the 19th, 10 a.m. at the Burka Educational Center. The Tippecanoe Valley High School's graduation is Sunday, June the 5th. Baccalaureate is at 2 p.m. and the commencement is at 2:45 p.m. And at this time, I will turn it over to Mr. Boggs and spotlight on the valley.
Okay. We have a couple of new employees here this evening that we'd like to welcome and introduce. And we'll start with Beth Landis. And Beth, hopefully here in a little bit, the board will approve her as our new family and consumer science teacher at Tippecanoe Valley High School. Beth, would you stand and introduce yourself and take your family?
Hi. It is so nice, such a blessing to be home. I am just so excited to be home. So Pastor Amber talked about the three phases of love, and I tell you what, I feel it. I love sharing love, I love giving love, I love these high school students, and I am just so excited to be back home and to give back to this community what the community has given to me, because I'm a 1987 graduate of Tippecanoe Valley High School, so I'm just so excited to be able to give back. Some of the oldsters are still around. That I had, so it's just very nice, and thank you.
Thank you, Beth. Welcome. And we also have with us tonight Jennifer Kimball. Jennifer is taking over at Burkett as head custodian there. And Jenny, welcome.
Thank you. I'd like to say thank you to welcome me back. And I was here a few years ago when I went to Rochester, and I'm back home now, so I feel more at home. I graduated also from Valley, so I feel really proud to be back. And to run the Burkett building, it's very interesting and something new, a challenge for me, so I really like it and look forward to all the new and exciting people I'll be meeting.
Thank you. Welcome, Jim. Is there anybody here that I missed? All right, thank you very much. All right, Mr. Doms, I believe you have some groups you'd like to recognize this evening.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Boggs, and I just want to welcome everyone. Thank you so much for coming out. And I know, parents, this is a busy time of the year, so thank you for taking the time to, you know, bring your family out to support us. I feel really blessed at Mentone in that we have a lot of staff members who just don't come in to do their job. They're really investing. And I'm going to introduce Mrs. Hartzler. She actually runs numbers for me and things in the office, but she extends beyond that and is actually one of our student council supervisors. And so we have a wonderful student council here. So Mrs. Hartzler, go ahead and take it away.
Thank you, Mr. Doms. This year at Mentone Elementary, we had 20 student council members, and that ranged from third, fourth, and fifth grade. They, in September, had to do an election. They had to have their classmates vote on them, and they were selected, and they have fulfilled their roles for the school year. At this time, I would like to introduce the members that are here. And when I call your name, if you will come forward, but if everybody could please hold their applause till everybody is up here, I would appreciate it. I have Molly Moriarty, our student council president. Dominic Utter, student council vice president. Cadence Malott, student council secretary. Evan Mash, student council member. Corinna Stiles, student council member. Brendan Stump, student council member. Brittany Benn, student council member. Kalani Barden, student council member. Kynan Cords, student council member. Maddie Poe. Sydney Nelson. Carson Kraft. Michaeli Costello. Cade Francis. Lydia Craig. Michael Leininger. Taylor Owens, Blaine Sheets, Madison Thompson, and Reed Jones. One of the responsibilities that these fine, outstanding leaders had this year was recycling every Friday. And they went around through the whole entire school and collected the recycling, distributed it out back, and had it ready for our custodians to take to the main campus. And I will tell you, this is the first year that I've not had any complaints of noise in the hallways on Fridays during class time. So this group did an excellent job. And let me tell you, that's huge for us as sponsors to hear those kind things. The other thing we did for the first time, we raised $1,000 for the K.C. Riley Kids Fund. And the K.C. Riley Kids Fund is an organization through the Community Foundation in Kosciuszko County, where $500 of that goes to Riley, and the other $500 stays here in Kosciuszko County to help provide transportation and food and such for those families to get their kids to the to Riley Children's Hospital. They also met monthly, and they also did labels for education, and we collected those. They spent many times pasting those to papers on a paper to send to the company, and we purchased inside recess activities for the teachers. So that's just a few of the many things we've done this school year. But if you would please give them a round of applause. For their effort. You guys may be seated. Mrs. Smith will be up to recognize our spell bowl members.
So when you ask kids if they'd like to join a team, you don't normally get a whole lot of enthusiastic response when you say it's a spelling team. For some reason, that just doesn't conjure up a lot of excitement. But we actually had a lot of kids who tried out for the Spell Bowl team, and we could only have we could only compete with up to 12. But so we kind of limited our team to that number. But we did have a good success this year. We competed in November. Our season starts right at the beginning of the year, and it's over by this year we competed on November 19th at Wabash, and there were seven teams in our division, and we placed third. So I'd like to thank the parents who supported their students and were able to pick them up after practice. I'd like to thank the kids for being faithful to come to practice and for a good job at the Spell Bowl competition. I have with me here Kiara Smythe, McKenna Rentschler, and Lorna Apt. Thank you, girls, for coming. And also on the team were Shelby Becker, Abby Bowers, Abby Brubaker, Kennedy Kohler, Evan Mesh, Gabriel Murillo, Shaylin Wilcox, Jessa Schroeder. So thank you, girls, and let's give them a round of applause.
All right, I see Mrs. Ryman in attendance, and so if you could come on up, Mrs. Ryman, and talk a little bit about the math team. And they had a lot of success this year. We're really proud of them.
Right, this year was a little bit different because we had snow days the day of competition. So we were not able to go to the regional competition this year, which was really disappointing. But we were able to put together the competition with the questions at our school the next day. So Akron came over, and it was just the Akron and Mentone teams competing. So fourth grade team, they really didn't have anybody to compete with at our competition because we're the only ones that have a fourth grade team, but they did a great job. Fourth grade team, would you guys go ahead and come up? Mentone fourth grade team. And we have 12 members on our team. And those members are Lorna Act, and I don't have, you'll have your certificates at awards day, okay? Tiffany Bullington, is Tiffany here? Yeah. Kynan Quartz, raise your hands if you're here, guys. Cody Eastgate, Wade Jones, Ethan Kelly, Gabe Murillo, Sydney Nelson, Macy Peterson, McKenna Renshaw, Jessa Schroeder, and Kiara Smith. Smythe. Okay, and they did a marvelous job. Last year, my fifth grade team as fourth graders took 20th in state, and this year they moved up. So I'm hoping the same thing for these guys. They took, I think, 36th in state out of about 80 schools. So they still did really well. So next year, I hope to have them all back and competing at the fifth grade level. Okay, nice job, guys. Thank you. Then my fifth grade team, go ahead and come up. And I think I have a few, not very many. Too many things going on this time of year. In my fifth grade team last year, like I said, they took 20th in state as a fourth grade team. This year, they took 6th in state. So they really moved up. So they did an outstanding job, you know, even with all the snow days we had, trying to get practices in. And these questions that they asked, and they asked the same ones of the fourth and fifth grade, they all have the exact same questions, and they're hard. They're really very difficult. I have parents coming to me and saying, wow, I cannot believe these kids, elementary kids, are doing these kinds of questions. All right, my fifth grade team consists of Lily Alt, Alex Bailey, Abby Bowers, Jessica Brito, Caden Davis, JJ Flynn, Dale Four, Marcus Stansma, Abby Cook, Cadence Malott, Molly Moriarty, and Sage Truiski. And they did an amazing job. Thank you.
Well, students, we are so proud of your accomplishments. And again, parents, we really thank you for coming out this evening. There's a lot of great things happening at Mentone, and that I'm excited about. Tomorrow, our chess club will meet for its second session, and we're looking forward to having our chess club next year, that hopefully we'll start getting shirts and doing some competitions, things like that. We also, our district's doing a Project Lead the Way, where we'll offer robotics club next year and things. So we've got some really cool things coming up for next year. And I talked to Mr. Boggs and wanted the board, because we talked about Mentone a little bit, you know, what can we be proud of? And I saw a video where four of my teachers and fifth grade teachers talked a little bit about PLCs. And sometimes people may wonder, when the teachers come in at 7:40 to 8:20, what is it that they do? And so this is something that I thought would be really, really good for board members to understand what PLCs are and how our teachers are using them that 80 minutes a week. Thank you so much for coming out to Mentone.
We've been working on formal assessments quite a bit this year. We have in the background at the beginning of the year, we're working on Yale, so by most areas where we needed the most help. And then in the process, we're putting together assessments that will go along with those Yales. We have pre-tests and post-tests, so we've been working hard on gathering data during the pre-tests, trying to make sure that we hit on all the students that are really struggling and needing help. And then we put that data together and think about interventions and what we can do, and try to work on those interventions that would be most helpful for the students that are struggling the most for each EL. Then we work together with those tests, come back and put our data and stuff together, and try to think everything quick when we do the actions that try to help the students who did not do as well. Students who pass the pre-test, we try to make the arrangements. Things we can do to help build on that same skill, but maybe at a higher level. And that way, hopefully, the process are also getting a little bit more of what they need. Can you bring the camera to this?
Yeah, we are getting further ideas about what to do, too, about how to get through that particular concept to all students.
All of our formative assessments, I didn't say this, all of our formative assessments that we've heard back. And we kind of went through and looked at different, you know, standards, what the state was required, and then we came back and looked at the questions that were probably the most appropriate to match different levels of standard and make sure that we had what we needed to be able to get a fair assessment of what it is, and then we also, you know, gave what they do and what we also need to teach them.
So that's a little bit of PLCs, and we just like to, Lord, it's good having you back in Mentone. Thank you so much.
I'd like to ask Mr. Austin Nickerson to come on up at this time. Austin, can we have you just go over here and stand by the podium? I'd like to share a little bit with the audience here about Austin Nickerson. Tiffany Valley High School senior Austin Nickerson was recently named District Star in Agriculture Placement. The award places him as the top student within District 2 for a job in an agricultural field. The award's based on a combination of Austin's supervised agriculture experience program, participation in career development events, and leadership skills. Austin has an SAE that focuses around employment at several local businesses. Through his SAE, Austin has worked on a beef enterprise, a progressive club lamb operation, and completed work with 4-H management as well. However, his primary job has been working on a grain operation where he helps with all phases of the business, including tillage, planting, harvesting, and machinery maintenance. Austin's the son of Jody and Laura Nickerson. Austin will now compete for Section Star honors against two other students from Section 1 by participating in an interview and submitting his Hoosier degree for further evaluation. Austin has exemplified success within the FFA program, serving as a chapter officer for 2 years and completing in livestock judging, creed speaking, and essay writing over his 4 years. Austin will also be competing for Final Four honors in his state proficiency of diversified agriculture over the next week. He qualified for this competition by winning his proficiency area in District 2 last year and receiving gold status at state this year. And in addition to all of this, Austin has also been awarded a $2,000 scholarship from John Deere Greenmark. Congratulations. This was written, I think, a few weeks ago. So a lot has happened between now and then. What can you tell us how things went?
I didn't make Section Star. There was another guy who went to Prairie Heights High School. He had just a few more hours than me, so at this stage of the game, it's all about hours. I got my Hoosier degree, so I'll be able to walk across stage at state convention in June. And my proficiency did not get into the top four, but he's still in the top eight in the state.
Congratulations, Austin. Okay, at this time I'd like to recognize Madison Miller. Madison is one of two Tippecanoe Valley High School students who serve as student representatives to the board. Madison is a senior this year, so she started last year as a junior, so she's completing her second year. She'll be graduating soon. And I'd like to have Madison come on up, and Mr. O'Brien's going to present something to you, Madison.
How do you get around here?
Can I squeeze through there? I'll squeeze through here.
Thank you for putting up with us for 2 years.
Thank you.
Now, Madison, come around here. We want to get a picture of the two of you here. Okay. We can. Anything you'd like to say, Madison, about your 2 years here?
It's definitely been a learning experience. I mean, a lot of people ask me about it, and I think it's really good to come and hear more about your school, and I've always had fun with you guys. You guys always make a point to talk to me, and I really appreciate the experience and the opportunity, so thank you.
Thank you. We have the honor tonight of recognizing two of our retirees. And what I'd like to do is read a little bit about each one, and then we'll have them come up. And again, Mr. O'Brien has a couple things to present to our retirees. First, we'd like to honor Marge Sanders. Marge is a fourth grade teacher here at Mentone Elementary School. And Mrs. Sanders will retire after 40 years of teaching, all of which have been at the Tippecanoe Valley School Corporation. She began teaching at Valley in the fall of 1974. That preceding spring, a tornado had touched down in the area. So her first year of teaching was at the Mentone Youth League with three other new teachers, Marlene Nellens, Jane Heiser Burkett, and Sue Grossman. She's taught first through fifth grades, with the majority of her time being spent in fourth grade. Mrs. Sanders indicates that she values the relationships developed with the students, parents, and staff of Mentone Elementary School through the years as the most rewarding aspect of her teaching career. Those relationships are what she will miss the most retiring from teaching. Mrs. Sanders looks forward to traveling, volunteering, and most of all, spending time with her family. We also have a second retiree this evening, also from Mentone, and that is Pam Smith. Pam completes a 37-year career in education. Her first year, she taught kindergarten at Brady Schrun Elementary School in Salem, Indiana. She moved to Mentone and spent the next 36 years here at Mentone Elementary School. During that time, she taught first grade for 5 years, second grade for 8 years, fourth grade for 1 year, sixth grade language arts for 1 year, and third grade for 21 years. One of the most rewarding aspects of her career in teaching is that she has taught two generations of students, teaching the children of former students. She loves to see how her former students have gone on to successful careers and accomplishments in their own lives. She enjoys the sense of accomplishment when her students show great academic growth over the course of a year. What Mrs. Smith will miss the most upon retiring from teaching will be the relationships with her coworkers. She feels fortunate to have worked with a very close-knit group of people who are always willing to help each other. Now, this hasn't changed over the nearly 40 years I've been at Mentone, said Mrs. Smith. I can truly say that I've worked with my best friends. Within the next couple of years, she'll be looking forward to relocating to southern Indiana to be closer to her family, her parents, sisters, and their families, and two of her own children live near Louisville, Kentucky. She plans to give piano lessons and hopes to enjoy grandchildren someday. So I'd like to ask Mrs. Sanders and Mrs. Smith, would you please come forward at this time so we can honor you.
Thank you. Enjoy retirement.
Oh, thank you so much.
Can we get a photograph of you later?
Do you want to down here, up there?
Where at? That'd be fine right there. Okay. Work.
Who do we look at first?
Enjoy retirement.
Anything you'd like to say, ladies, before we send you back to your seats?
I think Pam said it well when she said some of your best friends are at Mentone School. My kids went to Mentone from all the way and graduated from Valley. They're very successful. It's a great community to raise your children. Worked with some of the best kids, some of the best parents, and faculty members. So, mm-hmm.
So we both have raised our children in this community, and they've gone on to do great things. So we're very proud to have been a part of all that.
Thank you, ladies.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. And I would also like to share with the audience this evening that during the recent spring regional meeting of the Indiana School Boards Association, the Board of School Trustees of the Tippecanoe Valley School Corporation was honored by the Indiana School Boards Association as an outstanding board. The award was presented as part of ISBA's Certification Awards Program. Board member Tom Kraft was also recognized for achieving level one status as an individual school board member. ISBA's Certification Awards Program is designed to recognize officially seated school boards and individual school board members for their dedication to continuous improvement, especially through the attendance at ISBA-sponsored conferences and seminars. So congratulations to the board and Mr. Kraft.
Thank you.
At this time, we'll take a short recess and...
Hold on. No? I would like to inform the audience that it's Sunday, I believe, Rebecca, from 2:30 to 4:30. There's an open house here
for... Yes, in the exact same room.
For Mrs. Sanders and Mrs. Smith, right?
Correct.
A reception for their retirement. So, Sunday afternoon, 2:30 to 4:30, you're invited to that.
That's all right. We will recess and move down to the boardroom.
All right, we will resume our meeting, and at this time we'll go to item C, items from the visitors. Do we have any items from the visitors? And if there is, please stand, give your name, and then we'll go to item D, approval of consent agenda. Item 1, approve the minutes of the April 18, 2016 regular meeting and executive session. Item 2, approve the hiring of the following personnel: Beth Landis, family and consumer science teacher at Tippecanoe Valley High School; Justin
Wired,
custodian, Tippecanoe Valley High School; Vera
Witted,
custodian at Akron Elementary; and Jennifer Kimball, head custodian, maintenance at Burkett. Item 3, accept the resignation of the following personnel: Tim
Strela,
technology associate, Tippecanoe Valley High School; Samantha Levy. Math teacher at Tippecanoe Valley Middle School; Ron Bruner, head custodian at Tippecanoe Valley Middle School; and Andrea Smith, custodian at Tippecanoe Valley High School. Item 4, approve the maternity leave request for the following personnel. Valerie Lukens, kindergarten teacher at Mentone Elementary. Item 5, approve the 2016-2017 lunch prices. Item 6, approve the use of the school bus request. And item 7, approve math textbook adoption. Any questions from the board? Is there any items that you want to pull out?
I'd like to pull out the lunch prices and table that if we could for
now. Well, you just pulled out for right now.
Okay.
All right. Todd wants to pull out the lunch prices, item 5. Is there any others? Hearing none, is there a...
I'll make a motion to approve them, minus number 5.
Brian makes a motion to approve items 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 7. Is there a second?
I'll make a second.
Todd seconds. All in favor of approving items 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 7, signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? Motion carried. All right, we'll go to item 5.
Okay, we have one pre-written plan.
We're going to talk about item five. He pulled it out.
Yeah, he pulled item 5
out. Oh, I'm sorry.
I'd just like to think about that a little more, maybe get a little more information about it before we...
So you want to table item 5?
Yes, that's what I'd said.
We have a... you making a motion to table 5?
Yeah, that'd be fine.
Is there
I'll
a second
that
on that? Or
I'll second.
Anybody want to discuss it? Tom seconds that. All in favor of tabling number 5? Signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. So we'll table number 5 until next month to discuss it. How's that? That good?
Yep.
All right. We'll move to item E, approval of claims and payroll.
Okay. Sorry about jumping the gun.
That's all right.
We have one pre-written claim listing this evening. It's dated April 30, 2016. It's in the amount of $810,081.62. Our regular claim listing is dated May 9, 2016, in the amount of $116,257.08. We have three payrolls this evening. The first is dated April 1, 2016, in the amount of $392,075.38. The second is dated April 15 of 2016, in the amount of $389,659.79. And the third is April 29, 2016, in the amount of $359,619.65. And I submit these claims and payroll for your approval.
Is there any questions for Mr. Boggs?
Yeah, I've got a couple questions on the claims. Is there something wrong with our computer system? I mean, I see another server being replaced. Microsoft updates, which was $13,500. Server replacement was $3,000. Is there something wrong with our computers?
Can you also last month,
Keith? Last month we spent $20,000 for a new antivirus.
I'm sorry, I'm not sure what the claim is that you're referencing.
Did you just buy a new server? Or for asking for money? Asking for money for a new server? Is there anything wrong with our servers?
No.
The Microsoft update.
There's a Microsoft update also that was $13,500.
I think that's for Microsoft licensing, the license or Microsoft Office for the district.
Is that every year?
Yes, sir.
And then I saw a server replacement for $3,059.
Who's that? Who's the
I think that was part of our summer project, or not summer project, our Christmas project where we updated our core switches. We had one core switch that we needed to finish replacing on, and that was a final billing from that Christmas project.
And then, okay.
Yeah. That's one from the Rowing Corporation. The server.
Oh, okay.
You're referring to.
That goes to the...
It's the Rowing Corporation is who the vendor was.
Yeah, where does that server go?
Where's that server at?
That was not a server. That was a core switch in our network. It was not a server replacement. It was a core switch replacement. It was actually located in the middle school. At the middle school core switch, it was the primary switch that handled all the routing within the district.
Okay. Okay. How long is our since you're here, how long is our antivirus good for? When was the last time?
We renew our antivirus every 3 years.
When was the last time we replaced it?
3 years ago.
3 years ago?
3 years
ago. Okay. All right. That's all I got. Thank you.
All right. Is there any other questions?
Good questions.
No? Is there a motion to approve the consent agenda?
I'll make that motion.
The claims and payroll. Sorry.
Yeah, claims and payroll.
Tom makes a motion to approve claims and payroll. Stan seconds. All in favor of approving the claims and payroll, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Financial report.
Okay. You have the non-reconciled bank statement and monthly financial report of funds for the month of April 2016. A summary of our receipts and disbursements are total receipts for all funds for the month of April, $1,605,524.71. Our total disbursements for all funds during that same period of time, $2,061,125.96.
Any questions?
Nope.
No. We'll move to old business. Update on the Akron Elementary School project.
I don't believe any of our guys are here tonight.
No.
But they're going to be. But you're not here, Mr. Middling, to speak on their behalf, are you?
No, I wasn't. But
okay.
Not much to report right now.
No.
The weather. But
so what's going on there, Jim?
We do have about 600 feet of the 24-inch storm tile in, starting at the bottom end there at the ditch. And right now we're about 16 feet deep, so it takes a little while. But this rain has been slowing it down. Last week, I think we had one day where this week, nothing yet. It don't sound too good. So. But basically, what's going on is just a storm work at this time.
I believe that you fenced off the construction area now. There's a fence surrounding.
I fenced in the construction area, and this past weekend, they removed all the swings and equipment out there, and they've done a very good job doing that. Left in good shape. So.
Yeah, we were very pleased. The items sold in the online auction, the majority of the items went to local folks. So a lot of that stuff will stay here in the community, and they were like a bunch of bees out there Saturday. I mean, they worked hard getting that stuff out.
Good job.
We have groundbreaking next, what is it, Wednesday?
May the 18th.
At 1:30, so we invite the public to that, and as soon as school's out, things are really going to start to happen there, so a lot going on. Okay. Thanks, Jim.
Item 2, approve the revisions to the student, staff, athletic, and coaches handbook for 2016-17. Those were brought last month to us. Is there any questions that anybody has on any of those?
Yeah, I do. Is there anything that we can put into that now since we're having this class coming in to the high school next year, the strength and conditioning? Is there something that needs to go into the handbooks for the coaches and stuff that maybe they strongly suggest our kids to, if you're playing sports, needs to be or at least have that class? Is there anything that we might be able to put in this book here, the handbooks?
I guess we could, but the handbook that we have basically are the guidelines and rules and as far as that our athletes are subjected
okay.
to. So it's pretty black and white. And the strength and conditioning program, which we'll discuss here briefly, is more for the summer and also part of our curriculum that we would suggest.
Okay. All right, thank you.
And I would think the instructors for that should fall under the coaches' part of the handbook, right?
Well, that's what I was trying to do. No. Is
I would think they would need to abide by the handbook.
I would
get any rules.
There's an actual class in the high school for the strength and conditioning, correct? You can actually get a credit for it for going? Is that what I'm
understanding? That's what
it's going to be, yeah.
That's what we're going to discuss here.
Yeah, later. That's why I saw that and mm-hmm. I wanted to see if we can put something in there. Maybe if you play sports, that's a very good thing to be in.
Well, we can encourage it.
Well, that's all you can do. I mean, that's all you're allowed to do. But
highly encourage it.
So you need a motion to approve
it? Yes.
I make a
Is there any other questions?
Do you have any more questions, Tom?
No, that's it.
I'll make a motion to approve the resolution to the student, staff, athletic, and coaches' handbooks for 2016 and 17.
Is there a second?
I'll second
that. Todd seconds that. All in favor of approving the resolution to the student, staff, athletic, and coaches' handbook, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Is there any other old business?
No.
We'll move to new business. Accept a donation by the Psi. You say it.
Yeah. I know how to say it.
Megan, would you like to share what that's all about?
Absolutely.
I can say the SIGAPS, but.
It's Psi Iota Xi.
Okay.
We had a need in our school corporation for some hearing and hearing equipment for some of our students that have special needs. And one of the missions of this sorority is to help students with speech and learning needs. So I wrote a letter to them just requesting some funds and some support for these students. And they reviewed the request and they did graciously give us $445 to purchase two different pieces of equipment. And you know, unfortunately, no one was able to come from their sorority tonight. I did invite them, but to present the check to us. But they did mail it to me, and so I have it here to give them to Mr. Boggs at the end of tonight. So.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Do you guys need anything else?
Do we need anything else?
That's a crazy question.
We're asking it correctly.
Yeah. Let me just go back to my list. I think we got the two items that we really needed for the students specifically. And this is the sorority out of Fulton County, so these two students, that they do live in Fulton County. We will probably be purchasing what's called an FM system that goes with the boots that the sorority purchased for us.
Okay.
So any students are in middle school, high school?
There's one student in elementary and one in high school.
Oh,
mm-hmm.
Gotcha.
Good.
Thank you.
Do we need a motion to accept
yes.
that? Yes, sir. A
yes.
motion to accept that?
I'll take it or make that motion.
Tom makes a motion to accept the donation. Is there a second? Stan seconds. Any questions, comments? All in favor of accepting the donation from the sorority, signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Motion carried. Item two, approve the life skills curriculum at Tippecanoe Valley Middle School.
Mr. Backus is here to present that this evening.
Do they happen to get copies of the mm-hmm. curriculum piece?
They do.
Packages,
yep.
They got that.
Yep.
So we were approached by the Kosciuszko Cares Group. Marsha Carey came and spoke with us, and we've been looking at the middle school for a couple years now to put in a program to supplement our current health program that deals more with the mental health side of things. And so this life skills program, Kosciuszko Cares is doing a grant. We'll pay for the cost of implementation of all of this, and then it's going to focus on personal self-management skills, so reducing stress and anxiety, coping skills, problem-solving ability, managing anger, self-esteem, other general social skills like communication, building relationships, avoiding violence, and then it's a drug resistance, drug use resistance program as well. This is not going to replace our health curriculum, but it's going to go into our health curriculum, potentially through our health and our family consumer science courses and supplement what we're doing there. I believe there are 15 lessons that are about 40-minute lessons each, and so we'll probably use these a day a week or a couple days a week over the course of the semester with our kids that are in the health and family consumer science, so that we're still maintaining the regular health curriculum and family consumer science curriculum, but we're also doing some team teaching potentially to be able to bring this to the kids. Our staff at the middle school will be receiving some training on implementation of this as part of the grant funds Kosciuszko Cares has given us. So it's coming to us free of charge, and it's something that we've been looking to try to incorporate at the middle school anyway, so we feel like it's a pretty good win-win for what we're doing.
Great. Sure.
Okay. Any questions?
Somebody have any questions?
Great program.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And even though it's not the exact same piece as what Mike's going to talk about in a minute, it'll pair very well to get our kids prepared for moving into what they're going to do in high school.
So great. I read that over. I think it's great.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
We're excited.
Excellent.
About
good deal.
It.
Good.
Awesome.
Thanks, Scott.
Yep.
Is there a motion to approve the life skills curriculum at the middle school?
I'll make that motion.
Todd makes that motion. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Tom seconds. All in favor of approving the life skills curriculum at the middle school, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Item three, approve the I Decide for Me curriculum at Tippecanoe Valley High School.
This is a curriculum that Dr. Bennington and his staff would like to implement, and go ahead and turn it over to Dr. Bennington. I assume you'll introduce Amy for the board then?
I sure will.
Okay.
The I Decide For Me program is a four-day, 50-minute, or two-day, 90-minute high school program which is geared towards helping students identify long-term goals, give them concrete illustrations how to achieve those goals in healthy ways. This program will fit in with our health curriculum. It correlates to our decision-making processes and how decisions can affect your health and the long-term future. So I'm going to turn this over to Amy to maybe give some more background on it.
Sure. My name is Amy Rossworm. I'm the executive director of Heartline Pregnancy Center, also a Tempe Valley grad. That seems to be the theme tonight. At Heartline, what we do is a lot of crisis intervention. And so this program allows us to be able to do more crisis prevention at the middle school and high school level. So this program really talks about healthy choices and risk avoidance in multiple areas. So that would cover drinking, smoking, alcohol, and sexual behavior, and how all of those risky choices affect your short-term and long-term goals. And so what we teach coincides with state standards that teachers already have to teach either a semester or a year basis, depending on how you would like to set it up. So if there are any questions, I'd be happy to answer it. I know that you got the full background, so I don't want to repeat a lot of what you've already seen. We will have trained and qualified staff teaching the material as well. And it's free of charge.
Cool. That's really good.
Should I put that in earlier? We're seeking grant funding for all of the booklets. So each student would receive a booklet that coincides with the curriculum. And so our grant money would fund the actual booklets and then the salaries for our staff. So we really want the opportunity to be able to teach students about that crisis prevention and not always having to be there in the middle of crisis. That's of course still what we'll do when crisis arises, but if we can have more prevention of the crisis happening, meaning teen pregnancy, STDs, things like that, then we would like to be able to partake in that in the Valley School Corporation.
Great. Does anybody have any questions for? No?
Nope.
I think it's great. Good luck.
That's awesome.
Yeah, thank you for bringing this to Valley.
Yep. Is there a motion to approve the I Decide For Me curriculum?
I'll make that motion.
Tom makes that motion.
I'll second.
Brian seconds it. All in favor of approving the I Decide For Me curriculum, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Item 4, approve the Tippecanoe Valley High School peer tutoring course.
Dr. Bennington.
We'd like to offer a new class at the high school. It's not a new class statewide, it's just something that we'd like to reintroduce at the high school. Peer tutoring provides high school students with an organized exploratory experience to assist students in grades K through 12. Basically, it must be conducted under supervision of a licensed teacher. It's recommended for grade levels 10, 11, and 12. They can earn one credit per semester and it will count as an elective. Where we're envisioning this is using this in our life skills classroom. So we currently have students that work in there as interns for a good portion of the day. But we've got other students that would like to work in there, but might not have a full day or half a day to work in there. So here they could work for one class period, kind of explore the career, see if they want to be a special education teacher, help out, make some positive relationships with the kids, and still earn an elective credit. At this point, we see it happening in life skills classroom, but that's not to say it can't branch out into other areas around the corporation.
Cool. Anybody have any questions for Dr. Bennington?
I like it.
No? Great.
Thank you.
Is there a motion to approve the Tippecanoe Valley peer tutoring course?
I'll make one.
Stan makes that motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Todd seconds. All in favor of approving the Tippecanoe Valley peer tutoring course, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Item five, presentation on the strength and conditioning class at Tippecanoe Valley High School.
Ms. Burkhardt.
What I'll do is give some background information here. And we have several members of our committee that went to Center Grove High School, and we'll let them make some presentations here also. But just so you know, on March 17th, we took a committee of teachers and coaches down to Center Grove High School. We spent a good portion of the day with a gentleman by the name of Marty Mills, who's a strength and conditioning coach at Center Grove. He's been there for 15 years, and it was quite impressive with what we were able to observe and see. A little bit about Center Grove, they have an enrollment of 2,500 students, and 90%, we found out 90% of their student athletes are single sport athletes, which kind of raised some eyebrows for us a little bit compared to the multi-sport athletes that we have here at Tippecanoe Valley. But what they have is a very highly competitive atmosphere for their students to try to make varsity teams there. They also have a strong drive with their athletes in their off season to commit to the strength and conditioning program there. So we spent a good portion of the day observing the program. Committee members that went with us were Scott Smith, Corey Cooper from the middle school, which Corey, I think, spent some time there at Center Grove and was a big part of initiating this also. Mallory Eaton went with us, Greg Shira, Darren Hossoffel, Justin Brannock, Kyler Kirby, and Brittany Bush Garbers was in attendance during the time there. What you will hear from the committee members as they come up and talk a little bit is how they want to incorporate and initiate a full body strength program for all of our students and athletes at the middle school and the high school. Main drive is to make our kids better, and it will be a work in progress. It's not something you're just going to kind of wave a magic wand that's going to have full strength appear in a short period of time. So it will be a work in progress that we'd like to initiate. We need to take a look at changing the culture and mindset of our athletes pertaining to strength and conditioning in season and out of season. We feel it needs to be a big part of the curriculum at the high school. And at Center Grove, it is in their curriculum. I mean, they lift during the school day as a class. And there, again, is a big commitment from their athletes in taking that class and those classes that they have. Summer program is something that we want to start this summer here, with which the coaches will monitor. And probably the biggest obstacles that we have right now is the funding to obtain the equipment that we need and have stipends paid to the coaches for supervision during the summer. So that's just kind of a brief background history, and I will step aside and let other members of the committee who wish to present and talk, do that.
I have a question first. So this cost analysis, that total, that has the stipends in there for the coaches also, or is that an additional of these costs?
No, and I know Mr. Conley was working on a grant here a little
right,
bit.
Right, right.
The high school, middle school, I'll speak on behalf of the high school, we were willing to throw in $1,000 to $1,300. You know, we kind of ballpark figure, as far as equipment needed to get us started, we're looking at $4,000 to $5,000 at the high school, and I believe another $4,000 or $5,000 at the middle school to get us started. Although there was kind of an extensive list, which could run a little more if need be.
Right.
What kind of equipment is that, and what are you talking about?
Well, I think Darren and Mallory present. I think they'll present that.
Okay.
So you're looking at roughly $10,000, maybe $12,000 to get this started in the high school and in the middle school. When was the grant filed?
We submitted it last week.
Last week?
Yep.
Is that something that we can pay for ourselves, or as the school corporation, go ahead and buy that stuff for this program now? Can we do that?
And
then reimburse
grant?
With the, if we get the grant, but if we do not get the grant, then it's fine anyway. We need to get this class started. At least that's the way I feel.
We can look to see what the options are.
All right.
Okay. All the other members.
Uh,
One of the things that I really enjoyed about going down there, you know, obviously Center Grove is a much bigger school than us. There's a lot of differences, but one of the things I saw is we can do it. You know, they're not doing anything spectacular that is beyond what we're able to do here. And the program that we saw there, we can do. And one of the things that was very nice for me, maybe the best part of the trip for me was just the bus ride down, where we had kind of talked, and all of us coaches, we had the same vision. And the vision that we had was that for just a unified strength and conditioning program. Kind of the thing that we all said was, we don't care what program we're using, we don't care, you know, we don't care what it looks like, we just all want to do the same thing so that we can train our athletes in the same way. And you know, I had a conversation within the last couple of weeks with Alec Craig where I said, you know what, you can be a baseball player all summer, you can train baseball the whole summer, that's awesome, just come play football for me in the fall, because I know we'll be doing the same thing. And Jared Dusenberry, you can be a basketball player all summer, great, you know, no problem, you're going to be ready for football because we're all doing the same thing. And so we can really avoid tearing these kids all over the place. And and I think now is the time to do it. There is a momentum building, I feel, at the high school and in the middle school for getting stronger. This afternoon we had it open for football players and any other athletes that wanted to come. And the high school numbers are a little down right now because so many athletes are in baseball and track, which is awesome. But there was probably 25 middle schoolers that were there in addition to the high school athletes that we had. So kids right now are hungry. They want to get stronger. And so I think that this is the perfect time. Basically, what we saw down there at Center Grove was a combination of strength and plyometric conditioning. We saw a lot of things with functional skills, functional movements. So that in some of the things that we would need to purchase to move that forward would be ropes, sleds, and you can see this picture right here shows just part of what they did, and you can see it's nothing fancy. They've got basic ropes. They've got sleds that they're pulling and pushing back and forth. They have kettlebells to kind of help with the movement parts of the exercises, and also to help train beginning lifters and really work on gaining stability and that true functional strength that will allow them to move from the weight room to the field. And the next picture that we have up there, it just kind of shows how everybody's working together. You know, it's not this is not a football program, it's not a wrestling program, it's an athletic program. Boys and girls lifting together, all different sizes, all different strengths and abilities, and really focus on teaching the proper way to lift, a safe way to lift, so that everybody, no matter where they are, is able to progress through it, become more stronger, become more athletic. And so that's the goal, and that's the vision from the strength side.
And I'm sorry, what you saw, if you could back up, this is a class. This is a strength and conditioning class during the school day. And you can see how they're all centered around. These kids are on autopilot, but with the progression from the start of the year as freshmen to as they go through their sophomore, junior, and senior year. And again, it's very impressive to see what we have.
Not just the strength and the power. I love this community, and I want to see pride in all things. I don't care if you play golf, if you play volleyball, if you swim. I think something like this makes all of the kids athletes, and you're all on the same team. And one thing I feel like we lack here is some of that leadership. So this is accountability. This is bringing all the kids together, and it becomes this expectation of, hey, we're going to get better together. And, you know, I came from a school where it's a 3A school our size, and they did this. And I'll be honest, I was skeptical. I was like, boys and girls training together, you know. But I literally experienced it, and it was great. They pushed each other, and it really just built this, I don't know, this pride, and it brought the coaches together. And I know I want to be a strong force with them. And probably the biggest thing from it is, like right now, we do a little bit with the volleyball girls and the basketball girls, and you all know Ann Seacrest. And I've got sixth graders there, and there is nothing more motivational than when Ann Seacrest comes in and tells these girls, you can do this, let's work harder. I mean, that right there teaches more than anything I think that we could teach by ourselves. It just really creates this this pride, and that's what I want. I want to see it, one, so we don't have to tear these athletes apart. I want to empower kids to be multi-sport athletes, and I feel like in the world today, it's taking away from that, but that's just kind of what we're in. But this way, we all have the same expectation. Our kids are going to get better across the board, regardless what sport you're in. And then if we can put it in the curriculum, now we're saving time. I don't have to have a three-hour practice to put in lifting and put in conditioning. They can get it done at school, and they can do it together, and maybe somebody else says, hey, I want to be a part of that too. I see nothing but this improving all of our schools, at the middle school level, at the high school level. I mean, it literally is super doable. We've got coaches that care. We've got even extra staff that want to be a part of this, and I think it's going to catch fire.
Great.
I'm up for it. So do you want a motion?
What are we going to do with the...
Hold on. Oh, I thought it was approval.
It's approval.
It's consideration for
it's just
approval.
A presentation.
So we approve it next month?
This is like an elective?
Yeah, this class will be elective. It won't be required.
One thing I'd like to point out, like we're talking about lead times so for equipment and things like that, and I've been working with some details with suppliers, and there is a little bit of lead time to be able to get stuff purchased for the program to make it as functional as possible. So I like to point that out. I just wanted to talk just a little bit about the middle school and going along with what Mallory was saying. This would also help us get kids started a little bit earlier. And then also what we saw at Center Grove was having middle schoolers come in stronger, bigger, and faster when they were juniors and seniors. Like when our staff walked in, they were like, these look like grown men and women. And that was, you know, the real telling of the story there. So.
And it's going to be big to have the curriculum. We don't want to do all this in the summer and it go wonderful and then it just fall off. I know Greg Shira was on board and me and Justin Branagh at the middle school.
A lot of schools have it. I mean, my roommate from college, he coaches football at McCutcheon down in Lafayette, and he is the teacher for the strength and conditioning
class. And we have a lot of interest, especially at my level. I've got kids begging me for this kind of stuff, so that's going to be another point.
Mr. Burkhardt, what are we going to do about our basketball coach? I know he doesn't like our basketball players working out. Is that something that's going to be heavily... Hey, our kids need to get stronger.
Aware that kids are going to work out.
Right.
So, keep in mind, every coach that we have has strengths and weaknesses as far as on their coaching emphasis. So the thing we have right now is we have a majority of coaches that want to do this. As a athletic director, administrator, it's our job to give the coaches and the kids the tools and know-how to become successful.
And I want to throw one other thing out real quick along with this. I've kind of let Mr. Cooper run the piece here with Mallory and our PE people as far as what we're talking about with bringing things in, but we did get approval from Mr. Boggs to turn the old wood shop area into the middle school into our weight room. So over the course of the summer, the plan is to move what was the old high school weight room equipment that right now we have out in the pole barn that the football teams use. We're going to transition all that stuff into the building, into the old wood shop area, so that the kids have access in the building. And there'll be a little more space there, obviously, with heat and, you know, air handling system and everything. Cool. So we're going to try to make sure that we're setting up the facility piece at the middle school to help get this kicked off at that level successful for kids as well. So,
and with the middle school doing a feeder system for us, that would be huge.
And the
piggyback on this, but the middle school kids, they're not lifting to get huge. They're lifting to be just a little strong. Take what they've got, make it a little better. We're not trying to
We're not looking to, I mean, just to make the kids stronger, as you said,
the confidence and the form and the technique and those things that the transition to high school.
And we'll make them better athletes.
And while the summer will obviously be the prime time for training, you know, football is going to continue to do this in the morning for anyone who's not in class, you know, so any athlete is able to come in during the school year, during football season. When football is over, we'll be going in the afternoons and, again, just continuing the weight program really year-round. So while the bulk and the best time to train will be the summer, we'll keep it going.
Okay, great.
That's a good idea.
So it's just a consideration tonight?
Right now, it's a presentation to the board, but if the board would like to approve it for them to move forward, then we can do that also. So is there a motion for them to approve this strength and conditioning class? Stan makes that motion. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Kraft can second it.
Tom seconds. Questions, comments? And everybody's okay with this? All in favor of approving the strength and conditioning class at Tippecanoe Valley High School, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Approved. Go for it. Good
luck.
Thank you.
Cancel your summer vacation.
Yeah.
Appreciate your time.
Yeah. Okay.
Item 6, approve the adoption of uniform internal control standards of Indiana political subdivisions.
Say that 10 times.
Sounds pretty political.
That does sound political.
Indiana Code 5-11-1-27
reconfiguring.
Requires that all Indiana political subdivisions adopt the minimum level of internal control standards developed by the State Board of Accounts. As published in the Uniform Internal Control Standards for Indiana Political Subdivisions. So each political subdivision, that would be schools, municipalities, any government entity, must adopt these standards, train appropriate personnel, and implement policies and procedures consistent with the standards. So I'm asking for the board to recommend, or I'm recommending to the board that you approve the adoption of these standards.
I'll make that motion to adopt what you said.
Uniform internal control standards
for Indiana political subdivisions.
Is there a second?
Second.
Todd seconds that. All in favor of approving the adoption of the Uniform Internal Control Standards of Indiana political subdivisions, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Is there any other new business?
That's all I have, Mayor.
About student representatives, what's going on at the high school?
Yes, Miss Miller, what's your last report going to be?
Better be a good one.
No doubt.
Okay, a couple weeks ago, we had our IC internship banquet, which I thought that went really well. We had a really good turnout. Prom was this Saturday, and I'd have to say personally, the prom committee and like our prom sponsors did so well this year. It was so beautiful. I think we had so many kids there. Like, I don't think there was as many kids there last year as there was this year, and I just was really fun.
Where did you have it at?
It was in South Bend at the Brick. And I know a lot of people were worried about it being in South Bend, but I didn't hear really any complaints about the drive or anything, and everybody got there and back safely, so. And then as far as spring sports, I know TRC and sectionals are coming up, so just good luck to them.
There is. Speaking of winding down, we have finals coming up. A little bit of a stressful, sleepless time of the year. I think my bags actually have bags now. So we also have our schedules coming up. We got those turned in earlier this year, but it's getting things figured out. Okay, I have this class, but I can't have this class because this class is here. And so that gets to be a little bit stressful, but we're getting taken care of.
Jonathan, just wait till college, you think. This is good.
Yeah.
It's all fun.
Break them off.
That's it.
I don't miss those days.
Well, Madison, thank you again for spending 2 years with us.
Thank you.
And good luck in your future. Anything from the board?
No. Where are you planning? Are you planning
going
to school somewhere?
Purdue.
Sorry about that.
That's why I said
that. Hey, right there.
I don't know if that pin will work down there.
You don't need a pin. You go to Purdue, it's all.
All right, if there's nothing else, this meeting's adjourned.